Maybe Steve Hackett had too many ideas in his head to stay in Genesis. I'm John Bowden from Rock History Music. Steve Hackett's 26th album is At the Edge of Light. He's certainly been one of the most prolific ex-members of Genesis. He, along with Anthony Phillips, who's released a plethora of albums. Check out our exclusive interview with Anthony on this channel. It was actually Steve Hackett who replaced Anthony Phillips. Wind and Wuthering was the last studio album that Steve Hackett was involved with in Genesis in 1976. We asked him about all those musical directions.
When listening to this album, to me, it's another reminder, and I loved your work in Genesis, don't get me wrong, I'm a fan from right at the beginning. My thought, and I'm going to put words in your mouth, my thought was, there's no way this guy could be in a band with four or five other members, because there's just too much going on in your head.
Well, you know, there's a lot of stuff there, a lot of ideas, and of course in Genesis we did share tons of ideas. Together.
But you have so much on your own. You have so many things on your own. You couldn't fit. I don't think you could fit in a band, in that kind of band.
Well, it was difficult at times. You know, the keys to the songwriting cabinet could sometimes be very closely guarded. But we did manage to write together. And I think the best album for me was Selling by the Pound. At the time, 1973, that's when we were first touring over, you know, that side of the water. And John Lennon gave an interview and said we were one of the bands that he was listening to at that time. And, you know, it was very hard for us to get a gig, you know, that wasn't just a club gig back in the day. So, you know, that was very good news for us. That gave us some impetus, you know, the fact that we'd had compliments from the great man. And so, you know, that was an extraordinary time. And now I'm going to do the whole of that album when I go out on tour next year in 2019. The whole of Selling England and most of Spectral Mornings from my stuff and also stuff from this latest album, At the Edge of Light.
When you were putting this album together, like, how did it start for you? Did you have a grand idea? Were you reacting from something you saw on TV? Did you think it had to be told? All the above? How did this come to fruition?
Well, I was thinking about all the stuff that was going on at the moment and the political stuff. At the same time, you know, I'm primarily a musician, but Beasts in Our Time, for instance, was based on the idea of the Neville Chamberlain piece of paper, the Peace in Our Time, the check that bounced from Herr Hitler. I was thinking of that, and I was very much writing it with Joe as well, who's, you know, very, very politically aware. And then when I was naming the opening track, called it Fallen Walls and Pedestals, I was thinking in terms of the passing of time and, you know, glorious world leaders who just crumble to dust with the passing of time, whoever that happens to be. And then, of course, the last three tracks, which are Descent, Conflict and Peace, are really meant to be listened to as a kind of a trilogy. Yeah, the subtext, of course, is peace. But beyond that, the idea of spiritual dimension, the idea that we are spiritual beings in physical bodies, and many other things besides the belief in destiny and a kind of resolution, in a sense.
Yeah, I really like peace. I mean, I thought, thank you for ending it on an optimistic, and I like those three pieces together, yes, but especially peace. It's one of the most gorgeous pieces of music you've ever done.
Yeah, I like the last one. I mean, it's primarily a vocal piece, although there's instrumental passages. The doomy stuff that precedes it with the two pieces beforehand, they give me a chance to play some guitar, but, you know, that's not necessarily the star on that. It's really the writing, the idea of ensemble playing and orchestra and so many other things that piece is basically, it's a vocal tune.
I look at this project and I've listened to it quite a few times, and I'm in awe of the fact that, it took 18 months to do this, and it sounds like it took 18 months to do it because there's so much going on this project. Do you ever feel overwhelmed doing a project? Do you always know where you're at in the middle of it because there's so many pieces here?
Well, usually I'm if you see any of the videos of me making this album, you will see a worried look because I'm always thinking about a schedule that I'm trying to keep on top of. So it's not always easy to do that. Yeah, there's blind panic behind it at times. You think that, oh, I won't do an album as good as the last one. But I think this time it has kind of surpassed all expectations. I didn't expect sound so good. Production, arrangements, songs, the reach of it or the stretch of it, the broad-based thing, the fact that it covers so many styles, you know, again, this kind of global assimilation and comprehensive music and all of those things, plus the occasional pop song like Hungry Years, just to give it light and shade, and the Indian stuff, the kind of bustling Indian thing on Shadow and Flame.
We'll have more of a conversation with the great Steve Hackett coming up next week. We love presenting interviews to you. And let me tell you, you know, doing an interview package usually takes about between 10 and 20 times longer than doing just normal music news. But I got to tell you, I love talking to these folks. I love presenting very interesting people on this channel to you. And please, I always encourage you, if there's an artist that we talk to and you're not familiar with them, the reason we put the interviews up is we just think they're interesting people, whether they're rock stars or not. And I hope you feel the same way about our interviews. Make sure you comment on our videos, subscribe to our channel, and share our videos. Go to HackettSongs.com, by the way, for more information on Steve Hackett. I'm John Bowden from Rocky Stream Music.